Peter, what's going on? You know, Peter said, people say Peter ran away, you know what? I don't know if you remember this. He's sitting down on Messiah. The Messiah is asking him, who do they say that I am? What are they saying? What's the buzz out there? And everybody has an answer. It's so funny. When you need to hear someone else's revelation, everybody's ready to speak it. Everyone understands what the buzz is. They say you are a prophet. They say you're a great rabbi. They say you're John the Baptist, raised from the dead. They say you're Elijah. He says, who do you say that I am? He's asking this to 12 men. And the nut job opens up his mouth and says, thou art the fiest, fondest of the living is goddess. And Messiah says immediately, flesh and blood did not reveal that to you. Let me translate this for you. When Yeshua heard that, he also heard, bring, like he got a text from above. And Peter just looked down and said, thou art the Messiah, son of the living God. It's kind of like you're trying to take a test at school and you don't know the answer. But your friend, you know, call a friend. You got a hotline, you got a call line. They call you and they send you the answer. And you write in the answer and says, the answer to the question is, this didn't come from Peter. Peter, you know what he just said? He just opened his mouth. And he got a text from above. The problem with his texting system is that 2 seconds later he got another text, ring, and it said, oh, you shall never, ever, ever suffer, Lord, because I will not allow it over my dead body. And Yeshua looks at him and says, Satan, you are a stumbling block to me. Be careful what kind of text you're getting out there. Facebook texting. It's holy and unholy at the same time. Watch out that you're not getting your revelation from the Facebook. Become the book of the one whose face is on you. You're going to have to rewind that one on the tape. Some of these things, I've been asking someone needs to make Rabbi Peter for Dummies. I don't know. I'm talking crazy. I don't even know what I'm saying half the time. I got to go back and listen to it again. Says, Lord, what was that? God uses the same vessel who speaks, the only human on earth besides John the Baptist who recognizes this is the anointed Son of God. Two seconds later, nothing will happen to you over my dead body. And let me tell you something, Peter meant it. Out of the 12, he's the only one who would have really, really, really meant it. And he proved it hours later. Because when the mob came to get the king, Peter wasn't like, oh, you need this help, this Lord, oh, come on. Not by power, not by might, but by the Spirit, which is the Lord. Oh. Peter just looked at them. And I can just see him pacing. I can just see him look at these guys. And he just went down there. Man, I don't know, this don't look like a sword, but I just got to draw it out. He just took out his sword. You know, and I could just see him just on the sand. He's waiting for this moment. He is waiting for this moment. This is graduation time. I don't know what Jesus is thinking. Ain't nobody touching my Lord. And let me tell you something. When the mob came and they grabbed a hold of Yeshua, there was a young man who went over there. Everybody was grabbing him. And the first thing Peter did, he didn't talk about it, he didn't pray about it. He just came to lop his head off. Only problem is they had been celebrating Passover. In Passover, you have to recline. I think it was laying on his arms or something. His arm was kind of new. He's doing the best he can, but his arm is kind of like a wet noodle. And it gave enough time for the young man to duck his head out of the way. And let me tell you something. He was not aiming at his ear. He was ready to... Oh, but, you know, initiative. you know what I mean? Those of you who used to play Dungeons and Dragons, Peter didn't get initiative on that move. All right, maybe you don't know what I'm talking about, but you see, you got to roll an initiative, and whoever can move fastest is going to kill the next guy. So Peter lost that move. So he's like, and as he's doing that, the man, young man turns his head down, and that blade just came. I mean, it was going to lodge itself into his neck, but it just kind of bounced. And went chicking in his ear, like in slow motion, like. And it's floating around in the air. And Peter went down. And I'm telling you, he's about to come around. He's like, he ain't done. And he feels someone grab him and say, Peter, come on. Take a chill pill, dude. The Messiah goes down and he picks the ear up and he sticks it back on the ear of the kid. Kid's looking around wondering why he's making so much noise. Oh, the joy of the Lord. It makes a whole new way of praising the Lord. Just clap your ears to and fro. Hallelujah. What is it? Do you hear me, Lord? Do they want me to win? Do I tell me not? Can I tell me not? Can I tell me not? Do your ears hang low? That's when that tone started. Because all the people making fun of the guy had like a big old ear. You see, we're trying to figure it out, and this is getting out of control. We're trying to find out, when does this thing cross over? What happens? I'm going to tell you right now. Because when Peter saw that the King of Glory, the man who had him walk on water, the man he saw on a mountain transformed into the image and the presence of God, when he saw that man who fed the multitudes, who raised the dead, when he saw his Savior God, King, get dragged down the road, beaten and spit at and punched, and Yeshua didn't lift up a finger to defend himself. He couldn't understand what's going on. Everything he hoped for, everything he believed in, everything he sacrificed for was lost. You got to remember that just days ago, these turkeys were trying to figure out who's going to be the right hand of the king when the king begins to move in power and authority. Well, the king is about to die. So Peter sees this. And every faith, everything he saw, he began to wonder, did I just imagine this? What have I been smoking?